A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 20th August, on the front page you have reduced tensions with Pakistan. Trump. So US President Donald Trump has asked India to reduce tensions with Pakistan. Prime Minister Narendra Modi says that extreme rhetoric and incitement to anti-India violence by certain leaders won't help. So that's what happening in Pakistan. So that has been conveyed as well. We have seen the India-Pakistan relations, they have been strained, the diplomats have been sent back. And this is attendance thin as Jammu and Kashmir schools reopen. So schools have reopened in Jammu and Kashmir, but attendance is quite low. And top leaders still remain under detention. And this is NRC issues may be tackled via legislative group. So NRC exercise, which is a Supreme Court monitored exercise taking place in Assam. The National Register of Citizens has been updated to identify illegal migrants in Assam. But then there are concerns with respect to the results now. The final list would be published by the end of this month. The deadlines have been extended quite often. Finally, now the deadline is of 31st August. And the final NRC would be published. So, even claims and objections have been seen. Re-verification. In the sense has been done, but government, central government and the state government of Assam wanted further re-verification, which the Supreme Court rejected. So now it is said that if there are issues with NRC after the deadline, they will be maybe tackled via legislative route, means government would make law on it. On page 5, you have High Court seeks center's response to plea seeking same legal age for marriage. So Delhi High Court has got a petition which is asking equal legal age for marriage for men and women. So presently the legal age for marriage for men and women is different. For men in India, it is permitted to get married at or after the age of 21, but for women it is 18 years. So it's a petition saying that it should be same for both. On page 8, you have Polavaram. Center seeks detailed report. So this is in Andhra Pradesh. Reverse tenders call had been made. It was in news as such too. But now there is controversy over this, and central government has sought a detailed report on Polavaram project. So it's the Ministry of Jal Shakti which is involved here. You can see. So here you can see it was the tender had been issued, the lowest bid had come, and now reverse tender was sought, means a bid lower than what has been done presently too. You can see it is estimated to cost around 4,988 crores. Then below you have Supreme Court seeks reply from Karnataka on RT. So this in Karnataka right to education implementation, it is seen that parents want quota in private schools to continue even if government schools exist nearby. So Supreme Court is seeking reply from Karnataka government on this issue. And this is regarding nicotine. So nicotine class A poison in Karnataka. So government has taken steps to curb illegal sale, smuggling of nicotine cartridges and e-cigarettes, which are banned. On page 9, you have critical maneuver for Chandrayaan 2 today. So Chandrayaan 2 spacecraft is scheduled to undergo a crucial orbit maneuver today, and it is approaching its destination. So you can see this is the lunar orbit insertion which would take. So presently it's around the Earth, and now it will be inserted into a lunar orbit. So we have already discussed about Chandrayaan. It is a lander and a rover which would be a part of the mission. So Vikram lander is going to make a soft landing on the southern polar region of the moon, and that is scheduled for September 7. So presently the milestone which would be reached is lunar orbit insertion. On the editorial page, the first editorial is something special. So this is regarding the special relation between India and Bhutan. So we saw Prime Minister Narendra Modi was on a visit to Bhutan. The editorial says that India and Bhutan have good things going. Each must take the other's concerns seriously now. And below you have soldier number one. So this is regarding the creation of the post of Chief of Defence Staff, which was announced by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in his Independence Day speech. So the creation of this post is a comment on the security environment, is what this editorial covers. strained relations between India-Pakistan in context. The lead article, the far right's disruption of globalization. So Donald Trump's emulators have tapped into globalization's long-standing discontents. So like Donald Trump and his tariffs and such moves taken across the globe are actually disrupting globalization. So that is the far right group. The article below is on democracy under siege. So this is regarding how liberty, equality and fraternity are becoming subservient to a new idea of sovereignty. So India is a sovereign nation, independent nation. So to maintain our sovereignty, we are even trampling liberty, equality and fraternity. So that is the issue covered here. Then on op-ed page you have crouching tiger, hidden data. So the forest bureaucracy has ensured that tiger survey data continues to be withheld from independent scrutiny. So that raises questions because it has shown tiger population increasing, but is it true on the ground? If independent scrutiny is being done, data is not being provided by forest bureaucracy. So hiding data is a concern here. And this is, can a CDS act as a catalyst for further defense reforms? So we have the editorial also on this issue, Chief of Defense Staff post, which has been created now, announced to be created. So in India, strategic process delivers results only when it is backed by political heft, which this government can provide. So this is talking about the Chief of Defense Staff post as a welcome step. Then on page 12, you have India's bid for UN Security Council seat loses speed. So diplomats have called for a more aggressive campaign within the organs of the United Nations by India so that India can ensure its seat in the UN Security Council when elections take place now. And this is energy likely to be on Modi's agenda at G7 summit. So India is a special invitee at the G7 meeting, the group of seven developed nations, which will take place in France. So energy issue may be discussed here. And this is retirement age for central forces is 60. So Union Home Ministry has fixed the retirement age of all central armed police force personnel at 60 years. So retirement age has been increased. The reason for this being that they can serve for more years and they can actually, the pension which has to be paid to them, that cost of the government can also be reduced. Then on page 13, you have communities push for domicile laws. So Pandits, Dogras and Buddhists in Jammu and Kashmir are demanding maintenance of current population status and rights over lands. So though Article 370 has been abrogated and now land can be easily brought and sold, the demand from various communities in Jammu and Kashmir have been made to bring in domicile laws, maintain current population status and rights over land. Then this is India-China review border situation. So joint working group of India and China have met in Beijing to discuss the border situation. Then on international page you have troops assemble on Hong Kong border. So hundreds from Chinese paramilitary and people's armed police have been deployed in Shenzhen. So this here you can see your troops are being brought in because protests in Hong Kong continue and China calls them violent protests. And this is UK to end EU free movement for after Brexit. So after Brexit, UK would not provide free movement to European Union and government plans tougher criminality rules for people entering the country. And this is US gives Huawei respite on ban for 90 days. So US has now given Huawei, the Chinese telecom company, a 90-day reprieve on a ban against buying US technology. But then it has added that nearly four dozen subsidiaries of the Chinese telecom giant will be prohibited. Then on business page here you have DTC panel submits report. So this is the direct tax panel. So it has submitted its report, direct tax code, to the finance ministry. So this is a code which would replace the existing income tax act. And then here you have again passenger vehicle sales falling, and this is corporate tax will be cut gradually. So this is what the finance minister has assured. She says that the government will back wealth creators. And here you have Dr. Reddy's launches cancer drug in India. So this is Versavo, which is a biosimilar of Avastin. So this is a cancer drug which has treatment used for treatment of several types of cancer, which has been launched by Dr. Reddy's in India. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.